Hello everybody, this is Punk, Demon Neo, and welcome back to the Pokemon Fire Red playthrough. Last time, we conquered the Pokemon League by taking on our rival once again, this time for all the marbles to become the Pokemon League champion, and we were successful in our endeavor, winning the Pokemon League championship and getting enshrined in the Pokemon League Hall of Fame. But we are far from finished with this game. At the end of the last episode, after returning to Pallet Town, we managed to talk to Professor Oak, and he actually upgraded our Pokedex. We are no longer limited to just the Kanto Pokedex, ladies and gentlemen. We are now able to access the National Pokedex, which means we can now capture Pokemon that originally were not available in Kanto. We can now capture Johto Pokemon and Hoenn Pokemon, and basically we have access to all the Pokemon available as of Gen 3 at the time this game was released. Now, as to where I am right now, well, I am currently standing right outside Cerulean Cave, aka the Unknown Dungeon. Now, back in Gen 1, in order to access Cerulean Cave, all we had to do at first was beat the Pokemon League. However, in Gen 3, we have to do more. We are now essentially beginning the post-game segment of this game, ladies and gentlemen, and in order to get things rolling, first we're going to make a little trip to Vermilion City because, ladies and gentlemen, we still have some plot threads to tie up over at the Sevii Islands, because, as you recall, we've only visited the first three of the Sevii Islands. Now we're going to be able to access, or at least we're going to do something that will allow us to unlock access to the remaining islands. First thing we're going to do is we are going to return to one island from Vermilion City Port, and I believe we want to go into the Pokemon Center slash Network Center, and let's see here. We need to talk to Celio. Matt, how have things been for you? Oh, is that right? You've caught more Pokemon. Do you know what? Maybe I can be useful to you. I'm modifying the network machine right now. I'm changing it so that it can handle trades over long distances. When I get finished, you'll be trading for exotic Pokemon from trainers far away. But there is a slight catch. For the link to work, the machine needs a special gemstone. It's supposed to be on one island, but I haven't found one yet. Who knows where it could be? Alright, so the next major quest, if you will, is to upgrade the networking machine. And by upgrading said network machine, we will be able to trade. Not only will we be able to trade with Leaf Green like we already can, but by upgrading the network machine, we will actually be able to trade with the other Gen 3 games. Meaning, we will be able to trade with Ruby, Sapphire, and Emerald, as well as the GameCube games, Colosseum and XD Gale of Darkness. But in order to do this, we're going to need to find two gemstones, and the first gemstone can be found by returning to Mount Ember. Taking a little longer to get up here than I intended, but here we are, ladies and gentlemen. Now, you may remember there were two members of Team Rocket that we could not really interact with, but now, if everything's going right, yes! There will now be a new hole in Mount Ember. Whew! Punched through at last. Let's go treasure hunting! Any treasure we find, we haul back to the warehouse, understood? Oh, and what are the passwords? At the Rocket Warehouse, I mean. Huh, expository dialogue. What? You forgot the password. There are actually two. The first one's Goldeen Need Log. And the second one is...
Hey! This Snoop's been listening in!
Goldeen needs log. Something tells me that's gonna be important later on.
You've been eavesdropping on us, haven't you?
Yeah, and what are you gonna do about it, buddy? You wanna fight? Then we'll fight. Alright, so let's go ahead and get things rolling here with an Ice Beam on this Cubone, and dead.
You're dead, boy!
Alright. And why not follow up a Cubone with a Marowak? I like your style, sir. have the pre-evolved form and then the actual evolved form. Nicely done. Ha ha! And the freeze!
Freeze, mister! Big toe.
Yes, a SpongeBob reference. Don't like it? Get out of here.
Huh? What?
Huh?
Why'd you have to win?
Cause I'm the better trainer.
Trying to horn in on our treasure? Don't bet on it!
Alright, let's do this thing. Alright, this guy has a little bit of a... Well, he's got more Pokemon on his team, but he's really not going to be that much more of a hassle to beat than the guy we just defeated. Not a very impressive start with that Rattata. But of course, you wouldn't be a Team Rocket Grunt if you didn't have Eradicate. So I'll go ahead and bring out Falco. Kind of nice to have Falco back in the lineup. I mean, I did take Falco out and replaced him with Articuno for the Pokemon League. But since Falco is my designated flyer, I figured it would be a good idea to bring him back. And especially against a Sandshrew. Go ahead and hit you with a wing attack as well. These attacks, most of them are going to be overkill, I know, but... There's no kill like overkill, if you ask me. And Sandshrew goes bye-bye! And... let's see... I'll bring Seath back in. I really need to level up Seath. She hasn't even evolved into a Dragonite yet. And I would like to have a Dragonite. And dead. Alright, you both got your asses kicked. Get the hell out of here. Develop amnesia conveniently and forget everything you heard. What a setback. We'll have to regroup. You, don't even think about taking a step inside here. If you know what's good for you, don't even think about this. Oh, you fools. Don't you know that the more you tell someone not to do something, the more likely they're going to do it? And there's no way I'm gonna conveniently forget that I... There's no... Wow. It's really late at night, y'all, when I'm recording this. I probably shouldn't be recording this. That's why my commentary is kind of... right about now. There's no way I'm gonna conveniently forget that password because I've got it on screen. I would say I've got it on tape, but I'm not using tape. I bet there are kids these days who don't even know what a VHS tape is. I know what a VHS tape is growing up in the 90s. You would record TV shows and whatnot. Okay, so we have a little block pushing puzzle. You do want to bring someone who knows strength to get through here. Hopefully we won't end up needing Rock Smash. Alrighty then. How are we gonna approach this? Hopefully, you know, I won't be overthinking these rock puzzles. Okay, a split in the path. What does that mean? I hate splits in the path, game! I should point out that the later stages of the Sevi Islands, I have not retained very well in my memory. This is an interesting room. Has a lot of signs in Braille. Sadly, I cannot read Braille. I have a faint idea of what these things say, because I did look them up on Bulbapedia before recording this, but I didn't really internalize them. But this does actually have a message regarding the gemstones that you're looking for. Aha, here we go. We found a ruby. That seems like a precious gemstone to me. Sounds like something Celio would want. Man, I remember dealing with Braille puzzles, like, I think it was like in Ruby Sapphire, and I think even in Emerald 2, you had to do Braille puzzles to figure out where you could get Registeel, Regice, and Regirock. Yeah, those were annoying. I think at this point, we can actually just fly back to, where we need to go here. This is why it's good to have Falco back, my designated flyer. Alright, Celio. Oh! The Dats! Here's your ruby, sir. Thank you! Matt, you're simply amazing! I know I am. May I ask one more giant favor of you? While I was studying gemstones, I discovered something important. There is another gem that forms a pair with this ruby. That other gemstone is supposed to be in the Sevi Islands. Matt, please, I need you to go find the other gem. Matt, may I have your ferry pass and the town map? We now have the Rainbow Pass in exchange for the Tri-Pass, which means we can now access all of the Sevi Islands. So all the areas we couldn't explore previously are now unlocked. And there's really nothing else we can do here in one island for... Well, really, yeah, I think we're pretty much done here with one island, so... We're gonna make our first voyage to... Four Island. Oh, but look who's here!
Hey, Matt! What are you doing here in the Sevi Islands? You should quit copying me, you know. Anyways, I already got my Pokemon Egg, so I'm done with this island. Heh, I bet you don't even know about Pokemon Eggs. You'll never fill your National Pokedex that way. By the way, I saw someone we both know on this island. Why don't you go look around if it makes you curious? Me, I don't have the time to waste. Be smelling ya!
Figured it wouldn't be long before we ran into him again, but yes, we are now at Four Island, the warm, blue, flow island, and there are actually quite a few landmarks here. Most notably, we have an expanded daycare, and this daycare works like the daycare in Johto in Gen 2. Now we can finally breed, like the traditional daycare back in Kanto worked like the original Gen 1 daycare, where we could only keep he could only keep one Pokemon to level up. But now, with this daycare, it works like the daycare that was introduced in Gen 2, which means we finally have the ability to breed Pokemon, which I certainly intend to do. In fact... Hey, Lorelei lives here! Good stuff, good stuff. Alright, I'm actually going to have a little bit of fun with the breeding program here. Like, I mean, really, a lot of things really open up once you beat the Elite Four for the first time in Fire Red and Leaf Green and you get to really the post-game stuff. A whole lot of things become accessible. You know, the new Pokemon, breeding, among other things, so it's kind of a shame it takes so long into this game to get the mechanics going, but still, you know, it's nice. It's better than not having them at all, you know what I mean? Okay, so we need to speak to this lady. We can raise Pokemon for you. Would you like us to raise one? Alright. So I'm gonna go ahead and leave that Scyther. And actually, I will need to take care of something later with my Venomoth. I'm going to leave my male Venomoth and my female Scyther because of a very specific reason. I want a Scyther which knows Silver Wind, and I think breeding with a Venomoth that knows Silver Wind might be the best way. Of course, I could easily be proven wrong. Okay. Still have some other things to take care of, though. We're gonna go ahead and continue the quest for the, Sapphire, the other gemstone. Ma'am, yeah, I should not be recording this at... It's almost 1:30 in the morning, and yeah, my brain is kind of... not in tip-top shape here. Let's see. Gonna need a second water type for what I want to do here. Okay. I'd say that's good enough. The next place that we want to explore on Four Island, or Flow Island, we want to travel... First, let's actually go inside Lorelei's house. And she doesn't actually seem to be here. Got a lot of Pokemon here, though. Now, an interesting thing about the Sevii Islands, one note I want to make is actually about the music. The later stages of the Sevii Islands will actually contain several remixes of music from the Gen 2 games. So a lot of the music you'll be hearing will actually be remixes of Johto themes. Oh, chilly. I made a slushy using ice I shaved inside Icefall Cave. It's chilly and tasty. Interesting. Icefall Cave. Hope you've dressed warmly for this one, ladies and gentlemen. And in order to really explore this place, we're going to need to access a new hidden move. We're going to have to access HM7 Waterfall. We do get an Ultra Ball for our troubles, though. Now, the gimmick here is that you're going to be falling through certain sections of the level. And ultimately, we're going to have to do this little puzzle here in order to get HM7. And I think in the interest of keeping random encounters out of the way, I'm going to have to activate another Max Repel. Like, don't underestimate how much time you can save with Max Repel and being able to keep Pokemon from attacking you. And I don't think there will be any Pokemon that will equal Gamera's level, you know, level 60, so... I think we'll be fine. And there I go again! Taking that path made me fall the last time. Let me actually do this right. There we go, that's what I wanted. Now let's see if we can... Anyone remember the ice path from Gen 2? Well, it's back. Or a similar gimmick anyway, having to slide along the ice. Unfortunately, we can't really go anywhere. We can only go straight up or straight down because of the nature of the level design. We're going to have to once again utilize the trick of falling to a lower level. Let's see. Can we make this work? Hold on. Aha! Now, what items are which? Full Restore? I think the item that I skipped over is Never Melt Ice. Now, Never Melt Ice is an interesting item. It's a held item that powers up ice-type moves. Probably shouldn't underestimate the potential usefulness of such an item. But I might not be able to grab it on this run. There's HM7 containing Waterfall, and you will need Waterfall to get through the rest of this area. So that's why I brought Seadra, to have an extra water type, because I don't want to give it to Gamera. We'll go ahead and get rid of Smoke Screen. It's a shame you can't skip this animation. I like the presentation of these special animations and stuff, but they do slow the game down. At least in the earlier gens before this, you know, you didn't have these animations to sit through. But anyway, let's use Waterfall to get up here. And let's see, I think I can put Seath back up front. All right. Okay, and this should put us on the path to where we need to be. And hey, there's Lorelei!
Keep your filthy hands off the Pokemon in the cave! Do as I say, or you'll have me to answer to! Ah, shut it, lady, and leave us be! Don't let your glasses get all steamed up.
Matt, what are you doing here?
No, we can catch up later. Right now I need your help. Help me kick these poachers out before they do anything else. They've been catching Pokemon here, then selling them off. Are you ready? You take that one, please.
What? Who says we can't do what we want with the Pokemon we catch?
All right. Team Rocket makes their presence felt once again. So yeah, what was all that about Giovanni disbanding Team Rocket? Apparently these guys didn't get the message. Looks like I'll have to send the message to them.
One Zubat down, and Seath levels up.
Seath still has a ways to go before evolving into Dragonite. At level 43, it's got another 12 levels to go to reach level 55 and ultimately evolve.
Zubat number 2, down you go. And of course a Golbat.
I would be disappointed if we didn't have the evolved form, but all the same, it's time for you to go night-night. Which is what I need to be doing, quite honestly. I need to be going night-night.
Yeah, I see your confusion. Let's see. Bring out Gamera, why not?
Air Cutter, flying type move, not going to do very much, but then again, we're talking about a level 22 level difference between Gamera and that Golbat.
We didn't plan on this! Huh, so despicably weak. You, tell me, where have you taken the captured Pokemon? I'm smashing your ring once and for all. No way! I'm not telling you that!
If you won't confess, we'll deep freeze you! My Lapras is furious for what you've done to its friends! Go, Lapras! Ice Beam!
Ah! Okay, I'll talk.
The Pokemon are in the Rocket Warehouse on Five Island!
There, I said it! We'll be going now!
But I doubt you'll ever make it to the Rocket Warehouse!
Yeah, you better run.
Matt, thank you, but this is awful. I was born and raised here on these islands. I had no idea that those horrible criminals were loose here.
So, an interesting note about this particular area. I'm not sure if we can really look at anything because I've still got repel in effect, but this chamber right here, this pool of water, is, according to Bulbapedia, if I'm correct, this is the only location in all of Gen 3 where you can find wild Lapras. Which is very cool indeed, and a level 53 dugong in the wild. Holy smokes. Let's get out of here. And now it's just a straight shot to the exit, pretty much. We've taken care of business back at Mount Ember, and now Icefall Cave. I'm getting flashbacks from Freeze Flame Galaxy in Super Mario Galaxy. I mean, we've gone from a hot area to a cold area. Crazy how that works. Alright. So, what can we do here? Well, I don't think I'm gonna try to cram anything else like Five Island or any other stuff into this video. Maybe one more little thing I could potentially cover. Alright, so here we are back on Two Island, and we are visiting the house that is next to the Joyful Game Corner because we are going to talk to the Pokemon Move Maniac. I know every single move that Pokemon learned growing up. I'm also a Mushroom Maniac. Bring me two tiny mushrooms, or one big mushroom. If you do that for me, I'll teach a move to one Pokemon. Ah, you smell of mushrooms. Do you want me to teach a move to a Pokemon of yours? Okay.
So here's what the move relearner can do. He can teach Pokemon moves that they've forgotten, and there are some moves that really you can only learn via the move maniac. For example, Silver Wind for Venomoth, which is listed on sites like Bulbapedia as a move that it learns at level 1, which doesn't make a lot of sense. So that's where the move maniac comes in. So let's go ahead and demonstrate this. Now, if you're thinking about, if you take your mind back to that Scyther that I left at that daycare, you probably know where I'm going with this, teaching that Venomoth how to learn or how to use Silver Wind. Silver Wind is a breeding move. If you breed a Venomoth that knows Silver Wind with a Scyther, the Scyther that hatches from the egg will know Silver Wind. At least that's how it's supposed to work. If I'm understanding breeding correctly, I haven't really done any breeding stuff in a very long time. Like, trying to use breed, moves that are only learned by breeding and stuff, I have not done that in years. We'll see if it works, though. And on that note, we are stopping here. If I try to go any further with this recording, who knows what's gonna happen. This is Punk Demon Neo signing out on this episode of the Pokemon Fire Red playthrough. There, right there, I got my outro backwards. But anyway, if you folks liked what you saw in this video, be sure to leave a like, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. And once again, this is Punk Demon Neo signing out, and I hope to see all of you in the next episode!